Hey, Hugh from PCHC Mulgrave here today to talk to you about warming up. So, some kind of warm-up is always going to be important, but it doesn't necessarily have to be one particular thing. It's just a few boxes that we want to tick. So some important things: you want to raise your body temperature a little bit. You want to increase the pH in your muscles. You want to get into the mindset of being able to lift. You're switching over from work or relaxation to it's time to lift. And you're, you know, if you're doing something that's technical, you want to start warming up to be able to do the skill that you're about to do. So, one of the ways that we're going to start with some of those things is probably go do a bit of cardio. Your choice, whatever it is, nothing too hard so you destroy yourself. Just get moving, get breathing. That'll put you in the right space to begin doing some lifting. Other things you're going to want to do is you're going to want to maybe move the muscles and the joints that you're expecting to use in the training you're going to do today. So if you're going to do some deadlifting, you're probably going to want to do some warm-ups involving your torso, you know, things with your abdominals, your back muscles, perhaps your shoulders, perhaps your hips, your glutes, all kinds of things. You just want to move them, see how you're feeling. Because if you've been training hard, sometimes you're going to be sore, you're going to have aches and pains. It can be good to see where your body's at with all those things. Move and do some test exercises, see how you're going. And of course, when we're talking about being technically skilled to do something like a deadlift, you're going to want to actually take warm-up sets. And this is second nature for a lot of people, but some people are really in a hurry to get to their top weights. So, you know, they really, really want to just, okay, you know, look on the program. Sweet, it's a set of five at, 60 kilos, something like that. They're going to want to go straight to 60 kilos when it's probably going to be, you're probably going to get a much better result, feel a lot better, learn a lot more if you take some incremental jumps, you know, a couple reps with 30, maybe someone 45, maybe someone with 50, 60, something like that. Some particular increments that you can jump with. We actually have, of course, on a lot of our program sheets, we have a little calculator to help you pick your jumps if you're not sure what to do. So that's some general advice. Perhaps we'll take a look at a few of the things that we do recommend. So for example, one of the things that we use is McGill Big Three, which is usually generally like a core torso kind of warm-up. And we'll take a look at how you do that and why you might do that. Alrighty, so Emma just finished on the treadmill. So now we're gonna go and do some of our deadlift warm-up stuff, McGill Big Three to start with, and then a few other things. So we'll come on over to the mat here. And we're gonna start by doing a bird dog. So this is, you know, hands on your shoulders, knees on your hips, and you're trying really hard to maintain this stacked, neutral, like pelvis spine position as you move your limbs. Because that's something you do when you squat and deadlift. You move your limbs, you're trying to keep this really rigid. So let's have a few of those and then we'll move on. Nice, pretty rigid. Let's go to the next one, which is side plank. So same kind of thing here, different angle of the forces on your body, of course, but you're still trying to maintain this stack, shoulders and hips. So everyone's got a nice line, shoulders to hips there, trying not to, you know, sag down, trying not to have the hips be like too far back or too far forward. Really, really nice, warming up that rigid position. And then let's go to front plank, which again, exact same thing, hitting the same kind of task, which is the rigidity from all of these different angles. Just a bit of practice. For some people, this will be like worthwhile training for their abdominals, but for most people, it's just a bit of like a prompt, just a routine to get going through. And you can relax, Emma. Following that, as she practiced this skill, warmed the muscles of the torso up, we're gonna do a few other things. We're gonna do some RDLs. We're gonna do some rows or lat pull down to get all of those muscles for deadlifting nice and warmed up. And then we'll move on to actually lifting the bar. Emma's pretty strong, so we might start with like 30 kilos or 40 kilos and then incrementally build up to whatever her top weight's gonna be. And that should be as comprehensive a warm-up as anybody needs. Some people are not gonna need quite as much. Some people are gonna need a little more. But in general, you wanna do something with the muscles that are gonna be involved, and then you'll do your best performance. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them for us and we'll make another video for you. All right, we'll see you next time. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.